Hi children, welcome back to English class. In our previous class, we discussed Unit 6, Reading C, Children Speak Up. Okay, now today I am going to start, we discussed Unit 6, Reading C, Gulliver's Travels. Right, okay, that is Unit 5, Children Speak Up. It's Unit 5, Gulliver's Travels. Unit 6 Reading C, and today we are going to start a new unit called Unit 7, that is Reading A. Unit 7 Reading A, P.T. Usha the Golden Girl. I hope all of you have heard a little more about P.T. Usha. Okay, she is an athlete. She was an athlete, actually she is right now, she would be 56 or 54 years. I hope, let us see and calculate, okay. And now, before I start this lesson, you have something like warm-up activity, and they have shown this picture. Please look at this picture. I'm bringing very close to you. You understood that this is P.T. Usha, right? Yes or no? Have you ever seen P.T. Usha in TV, video, YouTube? Have you ever seen her running? I mean not live running, YouTube. Have you ever heard news about P.T. Usha? Have you ever heard her name, P.T. Usha? Okay, now let us know more about P.T. Usha. Before we start about her and biography, her parents and date of birth and everything, let us know P.T. Usha's this warm-up activity, this lesson's warm-up activity. You have to look at this picture and answer the questions that follow. Okay, which sports is shown in the picture? Which one? Which sport is that? It's running race, right? Yeah, correct. And you are going to write that answer before that question. Page number 91. I would like you to open page number 91 and answer the question. First question, it was a running race. Okay, the next question, which sport or game do you play? Which sport you are wishing? Now quickly write down, all of you have textbook and a pen or pencil with you, right? And you are going to write your favorite game or sport. Wait. You should know what's the difference between game and sport. The very next question is, what are the differences between the sports and games? Do you have any idea? Do you like to play sports or games? Which one do you like? Do you have any idea about the difference between sports and the games? Okay, fine. Now, here is my answer. I found this answer last year itself when I was teaching 6th standard, right? A sport involves individual skills, individual competition. Like running race, now see how many... she doesn't have team, right? P.T. Usha was running in this picture. She's running alone. In sports, it's individual participation, and you have some rules and set of rules and regulations that you have to follow. And it's a competition that you participate to compete your skills with another person's skills. It's an individual participation. Here is the definition. A sport involves individual skills and performance. And a game involves more than one person, so maybe a group of persons. Now you understood the difference between sport and game. Right? Now you tell me which game or sport do you like. Did you understand what I'm saying? Now let me tell you some examples of game. It's more than one players, like a group of players, like a team they play game. Okay? And one more difference I forgot to tell you. The difference between game and sport, the main difference between game and sport is We play sport for a short time, but we play game for a long time. What do you say? Did you catch my point? We play sports for a short time and we play games for a long time. Okay, that's the main difference, and also the players. And here it's an individual competition, where a team play. Team, and they have a goal. The team has a goal and they need to achieve that in that way. That's the difference between game and sports. Here is definition for game. A game involves more than one person, collective responsible of a team. That collective responsible you don't find in sports. Almost all. Okay, now you understood like high jump, long jump, disc throw, javelin throw, and running race, 100 meters, 200 meters, even 400 meters, short time, right? Very short time. Yes or no? Individual competition. And it's you play for short time, individual talent, okay? And if you ask me the examples for games, volleyball, basketball, cricket, and then volleyball, baseball, football, what else you could say, kabaddi, these all come under games. And now I hope you understood the difference between sports and games. First you write down below what are the difference between the sport and game. A sport involves individual skills and performance. Okay, let me tell you, a sport involves individual games and individual skills and performance. Skills and performance. On the other hand, a game involves, you are going to write these answers beside the textbook, so you should not forget the difference between the game and the sport. Involves more than one person. It's a collective. More than one person, collective responsibility of a team, comma. Collective responsibility of a team. Okay, this is the answer. Involves more than one person, collective responsibility of a team. Sport involves individual skills and performance, but you should remember that chess comes under game because they play for a long time. Yes or no? I said sports involves, of course, it's a individual performance, but they play for short time. But on the other hand, chess, it's a long, you could play even chess for 3 days, like many days continuously. Okay, so chess comes under games. So if we play for a long time, this is the form of oral discourse. Talk on why sports and games are important for children. This is for your homework, and I'm going to give you for paragraph writing, like home assignment, English home assignment too. I hope you couldn't see this. Now let me adjust this camera. Okay, fine. Now before I start about reading, P.T. Usha. You are going to watch a short video, okay? You are going to watch a short video about P.T. Usha. It's really and very interesting. I'm going to show you just P.T. Usha and about her family members, and just you see some clips of P.T. Usha, and then let's start this class, okay? Okay, now you are going to watch. Yeah, now welcome back to class. Now this is reading A.P.T. Usha, A India. Now, page number 92. All of you are ready with the page number 92. Okay, now let's know more about, you have seen only clips, some clips about P.T. Usha. I want you to know her. You should be able to identify the great renowned persons of our country. Okay, that's why some of you don't know who is P.T. Usha. She's a master. Okay, she's in Kerala. She's Kerala. Okay, now let's see P.T. Usha, something about her biography. Okay, P.T. Usha, India. This was the address on a letter from the Middle East. The letter was delivered by the postal department with no delay whatsoever. This was the status of Pillavalakandi Thakkaperambil Usha. What's her full name? Let me write on and you should pronounce and you should be able to say Pillavala. Pillavalakandi. P means Pillavalakandi. Now P means Pillavalakandi. Kandi? Yeah. P means Pillavalakandi and T means Thakkaperambil. 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 P-E-R-A. I think the P-E. Okay, Perambil. P-A-R-A. Perambil. P-A-R-A-M-B-I-L. Thakkaperambil. Could you see now? Pillavalakandi Thakkaperambil Usha. P-T means, P means Pillavalakandi Thakkaperambil Usha. Now let us know something more about, we came to know her full name now. We are going to know something more about her. Yeah. And Usha was born as second daughter of Michael and Lakshmi Amma on 20th May 1964. But you get in biography when you search Google. I got something like July 27th like that. But let's go with this one. Don't confuse about this. Okay, what they have given. Sometimes we change our date of birth just to adjust the years and months sometimes. Maybe there will be mistake in that Google or maybe here. But let's follow this. Okay. She was born on 20th May 1964. Payoli, a village called Payoli in Kozhikode district, Kerala. Okay, she was born on 20th May 1964 in the village of Payoli. Payoli, that's why she is called as she's well known as Payoli Express. She runs very fast, like a train, express train, and she's from Payoli, right? So that's why they call her nickname and they have given the title called Payoli Express. Apart from this golden girl, Oh, why she's called as golden girl? After finishing this lesson, you understand, ma'am. Golden girl is not enough for her. We should give some more and more and more renowned names, okay, to her. Okay, now let's see the next one. And she was born in the village called Payoli, Kozhikode district, Kerala. Okay. And then it was November 1973. Now we came to know about where she was born, who were her parents. Who were her parents? Paithal. Father's name, Paithal. Mother's name, Lakshmi Amma. Okay. Father's name, Paithal. Mother's name, Lakshmi Amma. Now let's go with the next one. It was November 1973 when a dedicated physical education teacher called Balakrishnan discovered Usha kept drifting to a Usha while conversing with a parent. Okay, first time she was discovered to a physical teacher. Physical education teacher called Balakrishnan first time discovered her talent when he was conversing with a parent. When he was talking with a parent, he saw a girl running very fast, very, very fast, like a born athlete. She was running. So he caught his eyes. He observed, he discovered this girl's talent for the first time. Who discovered? A physical education teacher called Balakrishnan. Okay? It was November 1973. It was November 1973 when a dedicated, what's the meaning of dedicated? Dedicated. Dedicated means devoted to a task. If you devote it to something and you work for that day and night, then it's called that certain XYZ is dedicated to this, and certain YZX is dedicated to this, that. Okay, you could say like that. So dedicated means devoted to a task. Devoted. Devoted to a task. Okay, you could say like this. Devoted to a task. Okay, next one. Next, let us see the next one. Okay, when he was conversing with her, a dedicated physical education teacher discovered Usha while conversing with a parent. His eyes ever watchful, kept drifting to a group of small girls playing blind man's bluff just across the field. Okay, once again, I read this. His eyes ever watchful, kept drifting to a group of small girls playing blind man's bluff just across the field. Was there a pair of feet, the girl in a blue skirt and white blouse, moving like an instinctual cat? Okay, he found a girl, some girls were playing in the ground, okay? Some girls were playing in the ground, and what they were playing? They were playing blind man's bluff. That you know, they tie their a piece of cloth to their eyes, and they play that one. During that time, it was not so necessary to run like that, but P.T. Usha was running like anything there. So he identified as that girl's talent as instinctive athlete. Instinctive means natural born, like born talent, you say, right? All of us, we have somehow we are the born talent. Inborn, we get some talent. So he found her instinctive athlete. That talent he found, that born talent. Instinctive means natural. By birth you get something. By heredity, by genes, you get some talent. Instinctive. Okay. Instinctive means natural. Means it's, you did not get it by practice or by hard work. You got it naturally, like inborn, by birth. You say inborn, and by birth you say that one. Okay? That he found in her. And she was in her blue skirt and white blouse. Okay, he identified, discovered for the first time P.T. Usha's talent. Okay, and now let us see the next one. Patient as ever, Balakrishnan waited for the game to be over. He waited and waited to complete the game and go and speak with her. Okay? And calling the little girl, he gently inquired of her, "What's your name, child?" The shy little girl hardly raised her eyes from the ground. "Usha," she whispered, and added, "From class 4. She was just 4th standard when the famous, the dedicated physical education teacher called Balakrishnan discovered her in the ground. She did not say only her name. When he asked her, "Tell her name, what's your name?" he inquired. She's like, "Usha, from class 4. Even she mentioned the class also. And that was one of the greatest discoveries in the athletic arena of Asia. That Asian stadium, not only she is famous for that arena, means the place where the arena. Arena, A-R-E-N-A. Arena means it's a stadium or a place or a ground where we play sports and games. Okay? So the discoveries in the athletic arena of Asia, a simple question from an observant master and an equally assuming answer from a tiny village girl from a distant village in Malabar in Kerala. A simple question, what's your name? Usha. Unassuming, unexpect, unguess. It's not at all guessed that by this answer, by this meet with that person could make her a famous runner, famous athlete in the world or in the country, in the continent, Asian continent. A simple question started conversing and he made it. He gave her practice and lifted her up high, above the mountain. Okay, now let's see next what happened. That same evening at 4:15 p.m., Usha heard the magical words for the first time in her life. First time she heard, and the same evening he went and he talked with her and he started giving her practice. And you know, Usha heard for the first time the three magical words. And what were those? Get, what is that? On your marks, get set, go. These three magical words she heard for the first time. Like you set time, you know, while running race, you kneel down and you straight, you will be ready for that one. And when they say get set, go, you start running like anything. Okay, now on your marks, get set, go. These were the magical words that Usha heard for the first time. The master had explained to her what to do and why. Confused but very much aware of the seriousness of the occasion, she ran for her life. The rest is history. Okay, she ran like anything on that day and she proved her talent and her skills. And rest became that history. Okay, that way she created a record. Now let us know how she started her journey of life, or the journey of her record life. What all she has achieved. Let us know how she has started. Okay, in 1975. In 1975, Usha was 11 years old and was practicing vigorously. Vigorously means with strength and energy. I think this they have given. Yeah, vigorously means she started working with them. Yeah, vigorously, V-I-G-O. Vigorously means with strength and energy. She started working on that day itself with strength and energy. Okay? And now let's see. Yeah. She was practicing before that meet. She was going to participate in a sub-junior district meet. Okay? For that, she was practicing vigorously with strength and energy, hard work. She was working very hard with her strength and energy. With 3 days to go, that sub-junior meet was 3 days to go, Usha badly injured her heel. She got her heel. She got hurt in her heel. Okay, while practicing for the long jump. When she was practicing for the long jump, she got hurt. The day of the event had arrived. All the people were looking at her. Okay? And they were looking at her, some bandage on her heel. See, the day of the event, all eyes were on her. She was so puny. She was looking so weak and small. More compared to all other, she was looking puny, means very small and very weak. Compared to other runners and other participants, Usha was looking very small and weak. And also she was looking very weak. Okay? And then let us see. And then she was so puny, so unbelievably tiny that she was the crowd's favorite even before the race has started. She became the crowd's favorite. All they wished, all they started encouraging PT Usha, maybe because they would have shown sympathy on her, and she was looking very weak and she was looking very small and she got hurt on her heel. That would be the main reason that she became the crowd's favorite. Okay? And she was the crowd's favorite even before the race started. A white bandage on her heel won her even more sympathy. I said, right, sympathy, because they would have seen her some, that bandage or anything on her heel. Okay? Sympathy means feelings of pity or sorrow. You see the word? Feelings of pity or sorrow. Feelings of pity or the sorrow is called sympathy. Okay? And then she came first in all the four events. She participated in 100 meters, she got first. 200 meters, she got first. Long jump, she got first. Okay, in all the events, she stood fast, and even they declared the individual champion of that sub-junior meet. Now see, she was also the individual champion at the meet. And then, up to now we heard, even in her 11 years, she achieved many things. She was very good at running, jumping, even high jump and long jump. She was very good at that. Do you think she was good at only sports? No. She was also good at studies. How do you say, ma'am? You see, next paragraph says about academic matters of P.T. Usha. Academically, Usha was an extremely bright student. She was always amongst the top three in her class and was popular with her teachers. And she passed her standard 7th exams with the first class grade. Okay? Just then, the government of Kerala announced a separate sports division for girls at Cannanore. She got first, and even in 7th standard final exams, public exam, she scored first grade. She stood first grade. She got first grade. And just then, during this time, the government of Kerala announced a special division for games and sports division for girls at Cannanore actually. Now they call it as Cannanore, I think. You check once in Google, they give only Cannanore. Here they have given Cannanore, C-A-N-N-A-N-O-R-E, Cannanore. Okay, and a town with a special facilities for sports in addition to regular studies. This division not only for studies but also a special focus on sports, especially for girls. So definitely this is a good opportunity for girls like Usha, who could concentrate both on studies and sports and games. So let us see in our next reading segment. This is reading segment 1. In our next reading segment, whether she joined there or not. Okay, whether she joined in Cannanore special division for sports. That's all for today's video. Bye bye for now. Have a nice time. Before we end this video, let's go through once again. That is dedicated, devoted to a task, instinctive, natural or inborn talent, arena, stadium or a place where we play games and sports vigorously with strength, S-T-R-E-N, sorry, S-T-R-E-N-G. vigorously, a strength and energy, puny, a small and weak, sympathy, feelings of pity and sorrow. Okay, now that's all for today's video. Bye bye for now. Have a nice time.